So this is basically the second most expensive race car you'll ever see, isn't that right, Richard?
Yeah, this is one of the old models we've had. This is now 2 or 3 years old.
So this is a wind tunnel model, right?
Wind tunnel model, half scale. This one's just used for training purposes now, when we have people in for training work experience, whatever, they work on this one before we let them loose on the current car. As you can see, it's largely made out of metal, machine metal, used for the main aerodynamic components. And then the little bits and pieces you see, the aerodynamic tweaks, these are all made out of resin or carbon fibre, which is made next door in the wrap prototype division, which you've already seen.
And so these are an exact 50% scale replica of what is on the car, is that
exactly correct? It's crucial to get the scale correct as well. This is why we use the Faro arm scanners to make so what we do is when everything we manufacture, we then scan in against the CAD, and then that is cross-referenced with what's in the virtual environment and the HPC, because we need to make sure that this car and the virtual car are the same, and then what we manufacture are the same scale as well. You can see we use a lot of computational devices, but there's all still the remnants of the flow vis, you can see, which mix of chalk and paraffin, which is the old school method of visualising the air. You see them at F1 tests on Fridays when the mechanics spray.
That's right, the fluorescent green paint, yeah, you can see it splattered everywhere, yeah.
Because you literally can see, because it sort of smears itself all over the car, so you can see the patches of air over the aerodynamic devices. This is one of the old ones, as you can see. You can tell it just has a generic helmeted driver. Now, the wind tunnel model contains a much more accurate version. We actually scan in Guido's helmet, including the spoilers, etc., or Charles for that matter, because, of course, the flow over the helmet has a knock-on effect to the air intake here. And over the back of the car, so we try and replicate as much as possible to the minutest detail.
So even just the fact that Guido or Charles's helmet might have a little spoiler on the back there, that can make the tiniest difference in the wind tunnel, and if you didn't have it, it could affect the readings.
Absolutely, it's just basic a question of getting as much information as possible. You'll talk about big data, it's all about information, so the largest amount of information we can put in, the more detail we can make this model, the more accurate then our aerodynamic findings can be. And therefore we cross-reference these with what the HPC produces, and that's how we come up with our aerodynamic solutions.
Wow, very cool.